Hi guys, it's Marty here from letsbuildwp.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install WordPress on HostGator Web Hosting. I'm going to cover the entire process from start to finish, and in a way that anyone should be able to follow along with. And I'll even show you how to get your first month hosting for only one penny. Now, I did already post a video covering how to do this a while back, but since then a few things have changed. So if you're ready to get started, this is how to install WordPress on HostGator Web Hosting, step by step, in 2021. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is sign up for a HostGator account by going to HostGator.com. Or alternatively, you can click the link in the video description below, and that's going to open it up in a new tab. But either way, once we get here, we're just going to hover over Hosting at the top, and then click Shared Hosting. That's going to show us the three different hosting plans that HostGator offer. Now, to be totally honest with you, the business plan comes with a whole load of added extras you're probably not going to need when just getting started, so it really just leaves it between the hatchling plan and the baby plan. And the only real difference between these two plans is the amount of websites we can have with each one. So with the hatchling plan, we can have one single domain, so one website, and then with the baby plan, we can have as many websites as we'd like. Now, because I'm only doing this for the tutorial, and I only need one website, I'm going to go for the hatchling plan. But if you want more than one website, go for the baby plan. Then, once we've decided on which plan we're going to go for, we can click the Buy Now button underneath. That's going to bring us to this page, and this is where we can register the domain name for our new WordPress site. So we just need to type the domain name we're wanting to register into this box, and for my example, I'm going to type NI Web Designs. Then once we're done here, we can choose our domain extension using this drop-down menu on the right, and I'm going to choose .com. So the domain name I'm registering is going to be niwebdesigns.com. Then, as long as it's available, it's going to say primary domain, but if it comes up and says it's not available, unfortunately we're going to need to choose something else. Then, once we've chose our domain name, we also have an option to buy other domain extensions as well. So we could purchase things like .org or .net, but we can always come back and purchase these later if we like. Then underneath we'll see it says Domain Privacy Protection, and this is an optional add-on. To be honest, I normally just uncheck this box and haven't had any problems to date. But if you want to keep your site totally anonymous, just leave this box checked and it'll be added to your bill. Then underneath, it says choose a hosting plan, and here we just want to check that our package type is correct and choose a billing cycle. So in this example, I went for the hatchling plan, so this is correct. And then here on the right, we can choose how often we'd like to pay for our hosting. And we can pay for it once a month, once every 3 months, or we can even pay for it every 3 years if we like. Now, we do save quite a bit of money the longer we buy at one time, so that might be something to think about. But as I'm just doing this for the example, I'm going to set mine to monthly. Then once we're done here, we can scroll down, and here we're just going to enter our email address and choose a password and security PIN for our HostGator account. Then under this, we can enter our personal billing information, so things like our name and our address. And then on the right, we can choose how we'd like to pay for our order, and we can choose either credit or debit card or PayPal. And for this example, I'm going to use PayPal. Then once we're done here, we can scroll down, and here we'll see it says Add Additional Services. These are just some added extras that HostGator offer, and I normally just uncheck these boxes myself, but you can have a read through them, and if you want any of them, just check the box and they'll be added to your bill. Then once we're done here, if we scroll down, We'll see it says, enter a coupon code. Now, there might already be a coupon entered in here for 20 or 25% off, depending on the offer they're running. But if we delete this coupon and instead enter WordPress 1 host, when we click validate, we'll see that we're now getting our first month hosting for only 1 penny. And once we're done here, if we scroll down, we can just double check our order's correct and see what we're getting. But before that, I'd just like to quickly mention that I'll be paid a small commission from HostGator if you make a purchase through my link or using one of my coupon codes. This won't cost you anything extra, and any money made will be used towards making more free WordPress tutorials. But I'm not just promoting HostGator for the sake of making money for my channel. I've personally been using them for over 8 years now, and have never had any issues. So even if you don't use my coupon or click through my link, I'd still highly recommend using them for your WordPress site. But anyway, let's get back to the tutorial. So here we just want to double check that our order's correct, and also note the free 24/7 phone, live chat and email support, and they also offer a 45-day money-back guarantee. Then once we're happy with everything here, we just need to check the box to agree to their terms, and then click check out now. So I'm just going to pause this video while I fill out my personal information above, and then I'll come back and restart it. So if you're following along at home, just pause the video while you're paying for your order, and then come back and press play when you're done, and we can carry on installing WordPress together. Okay, so that's me now back, and when I finished paying for my order, I was brought to a page saying thank you, and then redirected to the home page. So if you're following along at home, at this point we can actually close out of HostGator, and instead we want to open up our email inbox, where we should find a few new emails from HostGator. These emails contain some pretty important information, so we should keep them safe. But for now, we just want to click into the email that says Your Account Info. In this email, we'll see we have a link to our control panel, which is also known as our cPanel, our username and password for logging in, and some other information about our account. But for now, we just want to click the link to our control panel, which will open up the cPanel login screen in a new tab. Now we're just going to copy and paste our username and password from this email into the cPanel login screen. Then when we click login, this is us going to be logging into the HostGator cPanel, which is where we're going to be installing WordPress. Now this might seem a little overwhelming at first, but it's actually pretty easy. All we need to do is scroll down to where it says Software, and then click Quick Install. Then we're going to select WordPress in the middle, or if we don't see this, we can click One-Click Installs on the left, and then select WordPress here. Either way, it's going to bring us to this page, and here we just need to select our new domain name from this drop-down list, and then click Next. And now we're going to enter some basic information for our WordPress site. So for blog title, this is going to be the name of our WordPress site, and for me, I'm going to type NI Web Design. Although don't worry too much about this for now, as we can always change it again later. Then admin user is going to be the username we want for logging into our site. And then we just need to enter our first name, our last name, and our email address. Then once we're done, we need to check this box to agree to the terms of service, and then click Install. HostGator is then going to install WordPress for us automatically, and it's only going to take a few seconds. And then once it's finished, we'll be given a link to our site, our username, and a randomly generated password. At this point, we just want to right-click this login button and click Open Link in New Tab, which will open up the WordPress login screen in a new tab. And now we're just going to copy and paste our username and password from this screen into the login screen. Then when we click Login, this is us going to be logging into what's known as the WordPress dashboard, which is where we can add any content or make any changes to our new site, which, by the way, is now live online. All we need to do to visit our new site is click our site title in the top left. And that's going to show us the default WordPress installation. Now, sometimes they change the default theme, so yours might look a little different than mine. But either way, it's just going to be some demo content and not much else. But it's ready for us to start customizing and adding content to. And then to get back to the WordPress dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left. So that's us now finished, and that was how to install WordPress on HostGator in 2021. I really hope you found this video helpful and managed to follow along without any problems. If you did, please be sure to give the video a like to show your support, and consider subscribing to the channel for more WordPress tutorials in future that'll help you build and improve your new WordPress site. And then finally, just before you go, if you want me to show you how to build a professional WordPress website from start to finish, check out the video that should be on screen now, and there'll also be a link to it in the description below. This video, which is just over 45 minutes long, will show you everything you'll need to know to turn your fresh WordPress installation into a fully functional and professional looking website you can be proud of. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching my video.